These two cousins from the Black and Caspian Seas have hitchhiked their way from Europe to the U.S., zapping every ounce of food energy from whatever water source they inhabit. These filter-feeding fanatics can be found in lakes and rivers all across the United States. The zebra and quagga mussels are just one more enemy in this daily battle with the silent invaders. There's something therapeutic about the sounds of water splashing against the shore of beautiful Lake Superior. But all is not well beneath these tranquil waves. Just outside the Great Lakes Aquarium in Duluth, Minnesota, Doug Jensen uses a makeshift device to do a little unconventional fishing for an invasive species that has found a home here.
And we'll see if this works.
Doug slides his homemade trap up the side of the sheet pilings, carefully raising it from the depths of the lake.
We have one.
His prey is a small shelled creature that stuck itself to the side of the pilings. This is a zebra mussel, which in and of itself looks pretty harmless.
It's not just one zebra mussel that causes the problem. It's when we have millions and millions of zebra mussels on the bottoms of our lakes and rivers that are causing the problem.
And there are millions. Even more. The zebra mussel, and especially its cousin, the quagga mussel, have spread from the Great Lakes region like a virus and is now found across the country.
It's about preventing these things from getting into our lakes and rivers because once they're there, we just can't get rid of them.
Doug Jensen is one of six experts who will help tell the incredible story of how one small creature is having such a devastating effect on so many bodies of fresh water. Dan Malloy is a research scientist at the New York State Museum in Albany.
They can change the ecosystem in ways you don't want the ecosystem changed.
Dr. Russell Kuhl is a research scientist at the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee Great Lakes Water Institute.
There are undoubtedly many more individual quagga mussels than there are individual fish.
Byron Carnes is an aquatic biologist at the National Park Service on the St. Croix National Scenic Riverway along the border of Minnesota and Wisconsin.
Fish species that used to be prevalent in Lake Michigan are gone.
Jeff Weborg fishes Lake Michigan for a living.
We don't know if we're going to be in business from one year to the next.
Ed Rutherford is a research fishery biologist at the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration in Ann Arbor, Michigan.
We don't have oil spills in the Great Lakes, but we have something just as serious, which is invasive species.
And Tom Nalepa is also a research biologist at NOAA.
I never would expect an organism to become so abundant so quickly and have such dramatic changes as we have seen.
The first zebra mussel in North America was found in 1988 in Lake St. Clair near Detroit. From there, they expanded eastward to Lake Ontario and into the St. Lawrence Seaway. The quagga mussel was discovered 1 year later in 1989. The theory is that both species of mussels hitchhiked a ride from Eastern Europe by living in the ballast waters of giant ocean-going ships. Once here, the zebra mussel quickly spread by the millions throughout the Great Lakes. The quagga, however, took its time, eventually muscling in on the zebra mussel's territory, and is now the dominant invasive in unthinkable numbers.
There are tremendous numbers of quaggas in Lake Michigan right now. It's hard to imagine, but our scientist at NOAA who studies life on the bottom has estimated that there are over 4 quadrillion mussels on the bottom of the lake.
Jeff Weborg's fishing business on Lake Michigan near Gills Rock, Wisconsin, offers visual evidence of just one of the serious problems created by the enormous population of zebra and quagga mussels. As he releases gill nets out the back of his fishing tug, massive numbers of zebra and quagga mussels drop to the deck like hailstones. The mess they create speaks for itself.
It'd be great to see them disappear, but that's not going to happen. They're here and they're here to stay. And so now you figure out how to deal with them.
But the real mess these mussels create is with the ecology of the lake, especially since the quagga mussel has arrived.
where we had zebra mussels in kind of restricted areas in warmer water regions, now we have quagga mussels in both warmer water regions and in deeper cold water regions.
In other words, they're everywhere. Coming up, how quagga mussels are devastating Lake Michigan's food web, starving the fish. Plus, the destruction these underwater animals are creating is costing millions. And wait till you see what researchers at this little lab in the woods in New York State have come up with to wage a war against these invasive mussels. Silent Invaders is a production of the North American Media Group in cooperation with the Environmental Protection Agency and the Great Lakes Restoration Initiative, and by the USDA Forest Service, Wildlife Forever, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, the Great Lakes Fishery Commission, and these other organizations.